The president's medical team reported that on Saturday, Trump had started another drug to fight COVID-19, dexamethasone. It's a steroid that's been shown in clinical trials to improve outcomes, but is only recommended for patients with severe or critical COVID-19, which we are told he does not have. It's also the third drug to be administered to the president, following an experimental monoclonal antibody treatment given Friday and an ongoing 5-day course of the antiviral remdesivir. So the interesting thing about that dexamethasone is that it is one of the very few things that we actually have reason to believe can improve outcomes, like they said, but not just across the board for literally anyone. It's the only drug apparently to show improvement, but it gives a reduced risk of death versus those who didn't get the drug, but only when they're either intubated or receiving supplemental oxygen. So that might be a little bit confusing. Why would that be the case? That it's helpful if you have a severe case, but not necessarily if you don't, and they wouldn't even give it to you if you don't. Well, the reason for that is, it's a steroid, and the idea is that if you are severely impacted by coronavirus, your body might need that steroid at that point to help you continue to literally breathe. The thing is, if you don't literally need it for that purpose, the steroid is actually going to impact your body's ability to fight off coronavirus itself. So remember, we've been saying this for months now. You have to fight the virus, but you also have to fight the side effects of the virus and the damage that the medicine does to you. So either there's two possible explanations for why he would be on this treatment that he apparently doesn't need. Either they're being dishonest and he has a worse case than they're saying, in which case this would be a legitimate prescription, or he's being a VIP patient and he's saying, I want literally anything. It's not needed. The doctors might even be warning him against it, but he wants it. And it can actually have some bad side effects, which we're gonna get to in just a minute. But what do you think about this, Francesca? Him being put in this medicine that he arguably doesn't need, according to his own team?
Well, I think your two hypotheses are exactly right. Either we're being lied to about his condition, or he's just like, give me everything. What did Barry Bonds take? Inject it into me, you know? And y'all are the ones who are fans of superhero movies and villain movies and Marvel and DC and whatever else. Mm-hmm. This is how villains are formed, dude. Like, what did Wolverine get injected with? You know what I mean? Except he's a good guy, but you know what I'm saying?
This is sort of Hobgoblin, so Green Goblin style.
This is the origin story of the Green Goblin, y'all. Right now, whatever they're, because look, these are all experimental treatments. Now, have they all been experimented together simultaneously? So not only individually are they experimental, but have they all been used at the exact same time? Was there a patient whose life was supposedly worth, you know, more than the 210,000 other people's lives who weren't able to access that medication, for them to actually do that? And was that patient constantly whining about not being given more drugs? Because you know that's what he's doing. And I know you're gonna get into the side effects, and boy, oh boy, I think I'm right, man. I think I am right about this new, there's gonna be a whole new universe to talk about what happened to Trump after this. I wanna hear that, Sean.
So here's the thing, yeah, you're right. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.